Eric, I appreciate you coming on today. What I want you to do is just very quickly let everybody know who you are, the company you're with, and where you came from.
All right. Well, I work for IPsoft. I've been working there for 14 years now. I come from a strong finance background throughout the various firms of New York City. Work globally. What we're doing today is far and leaps and bounds different than what we've done in the past. We've evolved from a managed services company to almost the antithesis of a company that's bringing it back in-house and teaching our customers how to transform their organizations through the power of automation and through the power of artificial intelligence.
So what gets you excited about the automation and the artificial intelligence, especially when we start talking about financial institutions?
I mean, seeing them in the starting point of some of them struggle with, you know, how to evolve their organization, how to really change from just doing a standard body shop model, just looking for cheaper bodies around the world, and then taking that next step in that transformation and starting with automation and starting with the basics of around automation and then growing into the cognitive side of the house and really applying a real transformative solution such as Amelia, such as One Bank, or even One Desk today.
Okay. So how do you see this technology helping with here at Pay? We like to talk about the inclusion, financial inclusion, the expansion of availability and or really the understanding of money. Yeah. How do you see the IPsoft software doing that?
Well, I think the biggest challenge a lot of these companies are facing today is the cost of you know, low-level labor that's not necessarily growing that staff to other areas. And so they're stuck in these mundane jobs and these mundane roles, and they're not growing themselves in their careers. And so this is an opportunity to take the handcuffs off of that, take those shackles off, and really evolve their lives and careers and to focus on more impactful things for those companies. And so while you may have sometimes a slight reduction in some labor here and there, the growth of that labor is much more substantive and impactful for the organization and obviously for the world.
So you guys are seeing and this biggest scare that everybody has is that artificial intelligence, machine learning, all these things are gonna go ahead and they're gonna take jobs away. And from what I'm hearing from you now is that it's not that it's gonna take jobs away, it's gonna take the repetitive jobs and convert them into something that is a little bit more probably rewarding.
Absolutely. I mean, do you do the same thing you did 5 years ago,
years
ago?
No.
And did you want to continue doing what you're doing today, sometimes the mundane chores that you do?
I barely want to do the things I did yesterday.
Well, exactly. So what we want to do is eliminate those kind of roles, eliminate those kind of mundane chores, elevate everybody to a much higher level to where they can obviously have better paying jobs, better playing impact in the organization that they're working for, but also the world, a more efficient planet, so to say.
So do you see your IPsoft's role in the conversational commerce to be a really large one, or do you see it being more of kind of like a, I would call it an Intel Inside type model?
I think a little bit of both. I think you're going to see us more and more on the global stage, more and more involved in that C2B kind of marketplace.
Okay,
and
I think C2B.
Customer to business marketplace. Okay. And then I think a large role still to play business-to-business and internal to those organizations. I think our product offering is pretty broad, and I think each one of them has their advantages when it plays to those markets.
Now, is there a certain size or shape of company that really should be looking at this that maybe not might not be?
Well, I think the challenge we had is, you know, we do really well with a lot of the big chip, the blue chip players in the market today. And one of the reasons why we're here today is to reach out to those other areas, whether that's mid-tier banks, whether that's fintech startups, or whether that's organizations we haven't even thought of. It's the exposure from events like this that gives us those opportunities to discuss those, you know, those applications for those organizations.
So, speaking of this event, what is it, when you think of this event, who would you say should be attending and why?
Well, I think anybody who's in you know, thinking about financial technology and transformation needs to be involved in events like this. You need to see what everybody else is doing and what they're thinking. And you know, and how to apply that towards their organizations.
Wow, that was a really fast answer. So is there anything that we haven't chatted about today that you want to make sure that everybody understands?
Well, I think, you know, you touched on a little bit around the fear around technology. And I think we need to move away from that and embrace it. I think a lot of the roles that we see today are not even invented yet. You know,
okay.
And they weren't invented 5 years ago, and they're not going to be invented tomorrow. You talk about linguists getting involved in technology and teaching them how to speak certain languages and certain dialects. One of our largest engagements right now is Peruvian. They're handling over 4 million calls a month, and we had to teach it how to speak not just Spanish, but speak Peruvian dialect Spanish. And I think that's the kind of jobs that opens up the marketplace today.
Eric, I really appreciate the time today. Thank you so much, and look forward to you at the next event.
Thank you. Appreciate it.